Hello friends, so in this tutorial we are going to see how to calculate stress intensity factor from a singular element. So now I am going to teach you how to model a singular element in ANSYS, and from that how can we calculate the stress intensity factor. After that we will see how to calculate the shape of plastic zone size, what are the different things we have to undergo. So those things we will be see. So first we are going to calculate the stress intensity factor. For that first go to preference, structural, okay. Next you have to select the element type, add, you go for solid, coordinate 182 or 8 node 183. Better you go for higher order nodes, okay, so that the result will be very much finer. Click OK, then go to options, you select plane stress or strain or strain with thickness. Here I am selecting plane strain. Click close. Next, material properties, which material you are going to use, that you have to mention. So as it is a linear fracture mechanics problem, we are going for linear, elastic, isotropic. The value is 2e^5 and 0.3. Here the Young's modulus value which we have written is 2 × 10^5 newton per meter square, okay, and the Poisson ratio is lateral strain by linear strain, its value is 0.3, and click OK, and material exit. Next we are going to model the component. So first for that we have to go for key point. In active CS, all the values which we are giving are in meter, okay. And for creating key points, you can enter the value, or otherwise you can directly click on apply. It will automatically take the key point number and the coordinate. If you left it blank, it will be taken as zero. So apply. So the first point has already marked. Second point, 0.02. Third point, 0.1, apply, and fourth point, then 0, okay. Next we have to create line and made this to and form it into area. So for that line, straight line, click on node 1, key point 1, click on key point 2. Next link key point 2 and key point 3. Next link 3 and 4, 4 and 5, 5 and first. Okay. Next by using these lines we have to create area. So area, arbitrary bylines. So click all the lines and click OK. Now the area is formed. Next we have to mesh the component. So click on meshing, click on mesh tool, set lines, click the right side edge, click OK, click 4. Here in the number of element divisions you can put 100 or 50 or 700 or whatever may be. It depends upon what fine result you need to get, okay. In my case, as it is a demo, I'm just using 4 for easier calculation. If you are increasing the number of divisions, means the ANSYS will take little more time to solve the problem, okay. So okay, so this line is divided into 4. Next again mesh tool, line set, click this, again 4, then mesh tool, set this line, click OK. I'm just increasing the value to 0.6 0.2, okay. This is the spacing ratio. There will be some difference between this lining and this lining, you can see that. So here 4 4 6, and the spacing ratio will be 0.2. at this tip you can see the element length will be smaller. As it goes on, as we move to the top, the element length or the division will be increasing. That you can see after meshing. So before click on this mesh, you have to create the crack singular point. So for that you have to click on size control, concentrated key point, create. Okay, so this is our crack tip. So that's what we have given the value 0.02. so first you click on that point, click OK. You have to enter the value of radius of first rows of element. Okay, so I am just entering some value 0025. Then around this crack tip, so the first layer will be of 0.025 radius, first element. So around this radius, how many elements I would like to have? So number of elements around the circumference, I would like to have 8 elements, and this must be of skewed in the sense it will be of triangular form. Okay, so you click on OK. Now everything is over. Next you have to mesh. So click on mesh, click the face and click OK. So shape testing revealed that 8 out of 87 new or modified elements violate shape warning. Why this error is coming means 8, actually this 8 components are this thing, skewed elements. We have converted that to skewed, that's why that error has come. So no issues. So if you zoom that particular area, you can see so here you can see the skewed elements, a triangular element. Okay, so that is nothing but the skewed element. These elements are specially meant for singularity. So by using this element only you can calculate the stress intensity factor. Okay, so as I already told, we have divided this edge into 4, isn't it? 1 2 3 4, this edge also 4, and here we have divided it into 6. See at the lower bottom the division length is very small. When we move to the up, the division length is increasing. That's what the where the spacing ratio of 0.2 plays a role. Okay, next we have to apply the boundary conditions. Okay, load, define load, apply structural displacement, symmetric BC with areas. So click on this lower base, okay, then click on this area, okay, then again symmetric BC, this line, okay, area, okay. So now we have given the symmetric boundary condition. Next you have to apply pressure on this top line, top surface. So pressure on lines, click on the top edge, click OK. So here you have to give minus value because the load must be acting outwards from the center or the origin. So minus 100, click OK. Now we have applied symmetric boundary condition at both the edges and one pressure value at the top. Okay, next go to solution, current LS. Okay, now the solution is done. This box must be this box must come at once. When you solve by clicking the current LS, this box must be there. If it is not coming, means there is some error in your analysis part. Next, zoom this particular area. Okay, in order to find the stress intensity factor, we have to do some more things. So go to plus. So this plus symbol is actually for zooming. Go to work plane, locate coordinate system, create local coordinate by 3 nodes. Click this node, this and one vertical. So then numbering is 11, click OK. Work plane, change active coordinate system to our created coordinate system. So specified coordinate system, change this 0 to 11. Next, go to general post processor, go to path operation, So here we have to define the crack path. So by clicking nodes 1, 2, and 3, so this is the crack path. You just name it as K1 or anything else. Okay, so 3 points. Next, go for options for output. So here change the result coordinate system to local coordinate system and 11, then click OK. Then then go to nodal calc, go to stress intensity factor. So this is the plane stress problem, one half symmetric boundary condition, and click OK. So here you can get the K1 value as 26.500. So this is how we can find out the stress intensity factor value. Okay, so next what we are going to do is we are going to find out the displacement value and the stress values, and next how to find out the plastic zone shape. Okay, that's what we are going to see. So first we are going to see the result, plot result, deformed shape. So deformed shape only means you can see the deformed shape alone. So this is how this is deformed. Okay, if you would like to see the stress value means go to stress, then one basis click on that, then click OK. So this is how the stresses are varying. Okay, so here you can see this green region is 189.829. So this region is 147.08. For example, you consider a material having a yield. What is my plastic zone? If the stress value is exceeding the yield limit value of that particular material, means we will say that particular area as plastic zone shape. Okay, plastic zone. So for example, you just imagine, you just say, let's say 147 is the yield limit of a particular material. Okay, so now what I am going to do is I would like to extract this particular area from this whole thing. Okay, so in order to extract this butterfly shape, what I am going to do is go to plot control, style, contours, uniform contours. So here you click on user specify. So as I already told, my limit, yield limit is this thing, 147. Okay, I'm just naming it as 147 for the minimum value, and the maximum value is 403. You can just name it as 404. Okay, and click on apply. So here you can see, so this is our plastic zone shape. Okay, you can zoom it. So this is the area. After that, what you can do, you can go to plot control, numbering, node numbering, click on OK. So by using this numbering, what you can do is you can note this number. Actually, I have done a coarse mesh. If you do a fine mesh, means for each and every gap there will be some notes, so it will be easier for you to pick. For example, here you zoom and see 69. So this 69 node is having the limit 69 76 85. So like that it is going. What you have to do is you have to mark this node value 69 76 85. If the plastic zone is going like this, means you have to mark this. As I have done a coarse mesh, in between this node is not available. If you do a coarse mesh, you can get nodes there, so you can pick that nodes, you can mark that nodes, and you can get the values. So next what I am going to do is I am just noting down this node value 69 76 85 71 96 90 71 64 and 63 and 40. Okay, so after marking those values, go to list result, nodal solution, stress, one mesh stress, and click OK. So here you can see for each and every node what is the value. So from here itself you can conclude for this 69th point, you can refer it here. For the 69th point, what is the value? 230.84. So whether it is above the yield limit or below the yield limit. So like that you can conclude everything. Okay. So 69 is here. So 69, the value is 136. So like that for 76, you can go through and find out the values around 141.4. So like that you can check every values. So after that, in order to plot those things in Excel, what you have to do is you go to plot. Go to list, nodes, coordinates with angles are coordinates only. I'm just going for coordinates only, and click OK. So for example, if the node is 69, means you can get the coordinate, exact coordinate from this edge, left edge. If you would like to have the values from this edge, means at the time of modeling this problem itself, what you have to do is you have to take this particular point as 0, 0, and while modeling the left side you have to take the xy value as -0.02, 0, and the right side value you have to take it accordingly. So you must keep this as the origin. So by keeping this as the origin only, you will be getting every values based upon this, but here all the values will be based upon the left side origin. All the values which we are getting will be based upon this edge. Okay, so that is one thing you have to remember. So for this particular 69, what is the xy coordinate? So that you can get it from here. So this is the xy coordinate. So by using this value, x value, x distance means it is from this origin. Okay, this origin. If you would like to get the value from this point, means at the initial stage itself you have to model this point is 0, 0. So that is the thing. So like that you can get the values. After getting this stress value of that particular node and the location of that particular node, you can plot those things in an Excel sheet. Okay, so by plotting those Excel sheet, you will be getting a colorful butterfly shape. If you would like to have, this is only half model. If you would like to have half portion at downside, means you can get it from plot control, style, symmetric expansion, periodic or cyclic element. Click on this reflect about XYZ. So you'll be getting this thing. So we can off this. So you'll be getting a beautiful butterfly shape. Okay, so if you have any doubts, please mail me at jabinth@gmail.com, jabinth@gmail.com. Thank you.